Hello and welcome to the In Focus series section of Drishti IAS. I am Aisha Singh and in today's video we will be studying about the scientists at CERN observed three exotic particles for the very first time. So we will be seeing that what are these three particles that is so much in news and their discovery has made so much of headlines. So let's see the timeline of the video. First we will be looking at what is the news and the important points related to it. Then the experiment which resulted in the discovery of three particles, what are quarks, then the tetraquarks and the pentaquarks, what is Higgs boson particle, and the instrument which was used in the experiment was Large Hadron Collider. In the end, we will be looking into a prelims MCQ, and this topic is very important from General Studies Paper 3, Scientific Innovations and Discoveries. So from exam perspective, it is very important to know about the applications of the particles that has been discovered. As from science and tech perspective, the applications based questions are most asked in the exam. So let's see what is the news, and this news has been taken from the explained section of Indian Express, and it reads, the three new exotic subatomic particles discovered at CERN. So what are the three particles that has been discovered? So the particles that has been discovered are a pair of tetraquarks and a pentaquark. So let's see about them. That the agency which is responsible for conducting the experiment was CERN, which is European Nuclear Research Center. It was conducting an experiment on Large Hadron Collider Beauty experiment to see the slight difference between matter and antimatter. And the particle which was used in the experiment was Beauty quark or B quark. And when this experiment took place, what we saw was there was a discovery of particles which was never seen before. For the first time they were discovered. And it was a pair of tetraquarks and a pentaquark. If you will see these pictures, then this picture is of a pentaquark. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is a pentaquark which you are able to see. Then this discovery of pentaquark and tetraquark help physicists better understand how quarks bind together into composite particles. So now let's see about the experiment. So the instrument or the machine which was used in the experiment was the Large Hadron Collider, which was reignited after 3 years in April 2022. So after 3 years, this LHC was reignited, and when it was reignited, then it reached an unprecedented levels of energy. So much high levels of energy was used in it that smashing of protons started taking place at a speed which was similar to the speed of light. So what happened that in Large Hadron Collider, when it was reignited, then the very high levels of energy was generated. So when very high levels of energy was generated, what started happening? The protons started colliding or smashing with each other at the speed of light, at the same speed as the speed of light. So what happened in the end? That we were able to see a discovery of a tetraquark or a pentaquark. So this threw up new physics beyond the standard model of physics. So this is a very important discovery from the perspective of physics also. Now let's see that what are quarks. Quarks are the elementary particles or the most fundamental particles in existence. So, and they come in six different forms, that is six flavors, that is up quark, down quark, charm, strange, top and bottom quarks. So these are the six different types of quarks, and the quarks combine together in groups of 2 and 3 to form a hadron. So like imagine this is one quark and this is two quark, second quark. So So when they will combine together, what they will form? They will form a hadron. So similarly, when two quark will combine with one more quark, they will be in combination, there will be three quarks, then they will form a hadron. So the combination of two or three quarks forms a hadron, and when four quarks combined and when four quarks combine together, they form a tetraquark, and when five quark particles combine together, they form a pentaquark. So the exotic hadrons were predicted by the theorist about 6 decades ago. It is not that they were not people were not aware about these hadrons, they were, but it around 6 decades ago the theorist predicted about these hadrons, but their observations came in around in the last past 20 years. So they were, people predicted it around 6 decades ago, but their observance came around 20 years ago. Then let's talk about the tetraquark and the pentaquark. So according to the CERN, tetraquark and pentaquarks are the most exotic hadrons. I've just told you what are hadrons. When two to three quark they combine together, they form a hadron. So they are the most exotic hadrons discovered in the past 2 decades. And tetraquark and pentaquarks also have charm quark or a charm antiquark under it. So in pentaquark there will be 5 quarks. In tetraquark there will be around 4 quark. So out of 4 or 5 quarks, 2 of them are charm quark and charm antiquark, and the remaining 2 to 3 quarks can be up, down, or strange quark or their antiquarks. Now let's see that new exotic hadrons announced by the LHCs. The first kind of hadron that was announced was a pentaquark. Was a pentaquark, and the pentaquark that was found was to contain a strange quark. See, it is not very important for you to know that what was found inside it, but you should know that the two particles which were discovered, what are the names of those particles and what are the applications of those particles, that how they will be applied or how they will be useful for the for how scientists or the researchers will find them useful. And the second kind of hadron that was found was tetraquark, and in tetraquark it is an open charm tetraquark. So now let's see that what are the applications of subatomic particles. See, applications part is the most important part. What you should know from exam perspective, or even if you will see the prelims question paper of UPSC, the application based questions from science and technology sections are most asked. Even in the 2022 prelims paper, you will see that questions from science and tech were majorly application based. So the applications of subatomic particles were, they helped the physicist to better understand how quark bind together into composite particles. Then they also helped in the creation of the universe. They also helped in looking beyond the standard model of physics, and they also helped to answer the fundamental questions of particle physics. So this is how they will be helping, or this is how their application is. Now let's see about the Higgs boson particle. The around July 4, 2012, scientist at CERN announced the discovery of the Higgs boson particle, also called the God particle, during the LHC's first run. Then the God particle or the Higgs boson particle help in the formation of the universe after Big Bang. It is also believed to play a vital role in the creation of the universe. So the Higgs boson particles, one of the applications of the Higgs boson particle is also that it has played a vital role in the creation of the universe. So these particles, whenever their discovery takes place, they help to understand or to find out that how the universe was created, how it came into existence. Then for the Higgs boson particle discovery, the Peter Higgs and his collaborator Francois Englert was awarded the Nobel Prize for Physics in 2013. This was a very, very important discovery. So if someone is getting the Nobel Prize, you can understand that how big a discovery that can be. So now let's talk about the instrument or the machine which was used for the discovery of tetraquark and the pentaquark, that is LHC, the Large Hadron Collider. So Large Hadron Collider is a giant complex machine which is built to study particles that are smallest known. So it is built to study particles which are smallest known, or the fundamental particles, or the most elementary particles. So it is world's most powerful particle collider. It is 27 kilometer long and is buried 100 meters underground on the Swiss-French border. So now you are also able to see that what is the location of the LHC and its operational state. It is not very important to know about the operational state, but you should know that the machine which was used in the discovery of the particles was Large Hadron Collider. So I'll just tell you about the operational state also, that what happened was that inside the LHC, two beams of protons at the speed of light was fired in opposite direction inside a ring of superconducting electromagnets. So, but from exam perspective, this is not of very much relevance, but it is important to remember the machine which helped in the discovery of particle was LHC, that is Large Hadron Collider. So now let's see few of the pictures of the Large Hadron Collider is this, and see, this is LHC, the whole pipeline was going to underground. Now in the end, let's look at the prelims MCQ, and this question was asked in UPSC 2013. So this question says that the efforts to detect the existence of Higgs boson particle have become frequent news in the recent past. What is the importance of discovering this particle? So this, in this question, it is being asked that what is the importance of the Higgs boson particle. So there are three statements. First statement tells that it will enable us to understand as to why elementary particle have mass. We have just seen this. Then second statement says that it will enable us in the near future to develop the technology of transferring matter from one point to another without traversing the physical space between them. Then the third statement says that it will enable us to create better fuels for nuclear fission. So out of the three statements, you people need to tell me the correct statements, and the codes given are 1 only, 2 and 3 only, 1 and 3 only, and 1, 2 and 3. So let's see how many of you are actually seeing the previous year questions or are trying to solve them. We are trying to take all the topics which have been asked in the previous years or which are of exam relevance. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Till we meet next time, keep reading and keep writing.